So here's part two of Lucas Mill tips and tricks. Today I want to do my log bearers, show the log bearer system that I use for setting the logs in the mill. I wanted to do this video up there in the mill, but weather's a bit bad today, a bit bad this weekend. Had a good week, nice spring weather, but then as soon as the weekend comes, you got some time off work, yeah, bad weather comes in. But anyway, so what I want to show in this one is the log bearer system that I use. It's basically just two sleepers, just garden sleepers, treated pine sleepers. I think they're 1.8 long that I've sort of trimmed to fit in the mill and to fit on the back of the truck. Sometimes if I'm bringing wood home, I'll use these as bearers and under the wood on the truck so I can pick it up with the forks. Fits in my trailer nice and neatly for stacking the mill onto when you're transporting the mill. But the main features of these are, all it is a notch out of this sleeper. So with the Lucas mill and the amount that it drops down to, the stoppers on the bottom to make the low point, the lowest point that the blade will go to on the Lucas mill, the last cut on your log, so to speak, is around about 150 mils from the ground level that the mill's sitting on. So these are 200 mil or 8-inch sleepers, and the notch is cut out to about 150 mil. So pretty much the lowest cut you'll do normally is around about 200 mils from ground level. So with the log sitting in this notch, the last cut you'll do usually is sort of just above the sleeper. Occasionally, the idea with these sleepers is they're just a piece of treated pine and they're meant to be disposable. The mill has bits that are protruding down below the sort of height of the blade. On the edge it's got some stands, some of them, and the slabber has got a little bit that pokes out below the blade on the tips. So sometimes if you're trying to cut a really low last cut, you're going to have to sort of chunk bits out of this to try and get the mill past. So that's the idea with these, is doesn't matter if you cut into them, it's like a $10 sleeper. So, you know, these ones I've had for a good 6 months to a year, and I've chopped bits out of them here and there. But yeah, just really simple. Two 200 by 100 mil sleepers, which I've done notch out of that the log rolls into. So I'll just roll this log and we'll see. So it's sort of, you can see there, this is a pretty regular shaped log. I've just got this log, these two logs here for display purposes. So there you go, drops in. One of the trickiest parts of milling is setting up the log in the mill, getting your lines right. You know, you can use your cant hook now to sort of twist this around to figure out where you want to cut. But yeah, pretty much just, it's dropped into place. And if you've got these bearers set in your mill at the right line for the dimension cutter, the swing blade, if you're doing multiple logs, regular shaped logs, you can just roll the logs in, they drop into the same spot every time, and then you just start milling. There's no sort of shifting the log around, moving the bearers, maybe moving the mill to try and get the line through the log correct. You know, if you've got these notches and the next log goes into the same spot, you're going to be ready to go again. So yeah, that's a bit of a taper here, so you can roll it up. Easy notch out. These things take 10 minutes to make out of a sleeper. Chainsaw, you just do your measurements, make them both the same, ideally. The other good thing with this, sometimes if you've got a tapered log, you can sit the fat end down in the groove and have the other end sitting up on the flat. So yeah, that'll get the log nice and flat, give you a better line. One thing you can do if you don't have it sitting in the groove and the log's got a bit of wobble, I use my wedges to brace the log. So I carry around me on the job. I'm running low on wedges at the moment. I think I need to make a new batch. But yeah, a couple of ways you can use the wedges. I'll just get this out to make it a bit easier. So you got one end. I'll just work on one end at the moment. So you can just use your wedges. Tap it in. Another one on the other side. Chopped. Now that's fine for dimension cutting. But if you want to use a slabber, what I generally do is, I know there's going to be a lot of vibration, so these will probably just work their way out. The log will move. The last thing you want is the log to move in between slabs, because the next cut's going to be different than the last. So what I do with these generally is I turn them around the other way and I use it like a stopper rather than a wedge. All it's doing is stopping the log from moving. So then what I do is I just hold this wedge in place with a tech screw. So I'm tech screwing down here on the taper. So hopefully the tech screw is going to land lower than my last cut. I didn't really go into there, but it shows what I mean. Forces pushing this way, well, that'll hold in place. So, alright, I can hear everybody saying, oh, but there's steel there. What happens if you hit the steel? Well, this is the way I do it. My feeling is, if you're running one of these Lucas mills, and, you know, you're going to be silly enough to hit that, perhaps you shouldn't be running a Lucas mill. Because, you know, if you're not concentrating enough to know that that's there and not to drop the chain onto it or the cutter onto it, then, mate, you shouldn't be running one of these mills. You'll hurt yourself. Simple as that. Like, these things are deadly. You've got to pay attention. Something like that, you want to pay attention to. And, you know, touch wood. Having ever hit one of these things, just know when you get low, your offsider knows that it's there, you know that it's there. I've cut these tops off these wedges and just skimmed over the top of that, no dramas at all. So the other thing I want to show you with this, this setup, the reason why I've got two notches. With a Lucas mill, if you're dealing with, this only really works if you've got regular size shaped logs and regular size logs. So you're doing the same size log, you know, maybe you might have a big pile of wood that you just, all nice big long poles, you just do a whole lot of sort of, you know, 300-400s. Doesn't work for big logs, only smaller ones. So you roll one in, come on, stay upright. One log in the notches, so then you can get a second log. Second log, you can sit in the notch next to it.
can go along, cut two logs at once. So it halves your loading time. You know, if you've got a big log dump sitting out next to the mill and you're just rolling one after another in, two logs at once. So long as you can line up the hearts of the log, you can get to a similar sort of height, which you can do if they're same size logs. This works really well, really quick. On the next video, I think that's all I need to show you for these. My log bearers, disposable, easy to make, easy to use. Next video, I want to show loading logs into the mill. So there's a few different ways that that you can safely and easily get the logs from either beside the mill and roll them in or lift them over. Very rarely do I put a log in the end of the mill. Usually it's from the side, and that's the way you set up. So there's a few tricks to that too. So that'll be the next one. All right, cool. Over and out.